Tell him that my lonesome nights are over. Send gonna sail upon that ferry boat, never to return again. So goodbye,
farewell,
so long forever. Goodbye, my Coney Isle. Goodbye, my Coney Isle. Goodbye, my Coney Island Bay.
Obviously, we're in the 20th century now, right? We caught on to that. This next song has two stories to it. If you know Up on the Roof, the famous Carole King and her husband, Jerry Goffin, wrote Up on the Roof. It was a hit in 1962 for, well, maybe some of you don't know that. us cool ones, we know that, right? But it was a big hit for the Drifters, and people have, you know, sung it all the time since. It's a very recognizable tune, like so many of their songs and her songs. Everybody knows she had the top-selling record of all time before Thriller came out, right? Everybody knows that. It was huge. Please tell me you knew that. A huge Carole King fan. But yeah, Tapestry. And then they're going, oh yeah, okay. All right, well, at any rate, that's where the song came from, but recently a very popular form of a cappella singing has come to college campuses and high schools and just community people that do this thing called a cappella. And it's all just a cappella singing, no instruments. They have vocal percussion that does rhythmic things. But one of the premier arrangers is this Deke Sharon that has arranged this, and he is known as the godfather of a cappella arranging. He not only teaches the art form of singing it, but he also teaches people how to do the arrangements. And I don't know if any of these kids have done any of that arranging, but it's a pretty hot thing currently. So he writes very accessible arrangements, and this is one of them, and so proudly, it features our alto section. So you're in for a real treat. So here we are, Up on the Roof.
Starts getting you down, and people are just
they lovingly have to remind me of things. Patty, come on out, it's time. We have moved to the point where a lot of the traditional music from all around the world is making it into choral repertoire. And this is a traditional folk song from Kenya that Persephone Powell has put together for us to enjoy. And this is our guest artist, Patty Sterk, from a senior at Brockport High School, heading off to be at music school next fall. And anytime I need someone to play the djembe, Patty's there for us. So thank you for coming over today to do this. This is kind of a funny song because the text indicates that it's a conversation between a man and a woman. And what they're talking about is, I love you, but you do not love me. How is that? If you do not love me, you had better tell me so. That's what the song is saying. Okay, so hopefully you'll hear that with the dynamic contrast that we have and the wide range of layered vocal lines. They're going to be doing lots of different polyphony happening over here, creating thick and thin textures, and then the addition of Patty and lead shaker player on progression. So here is Ning Wendete.
Thank you.
maybe a couple weeks ago. I didn't know I knew this many a cappella pieces. No, I did know that. And I don't really know why I wanted this spring to be all a cappella. I think it was about really treasuring the sound that these singers work so hard together to make and how it affects the world and our daily lives. They practice an awful lot on their own. And Tuesday, Thursdays are glorious to come witness and be a big part of, because everybody includes everybody around here. So, and I love a cappella singing. I think maybe I wanted to give that gift to you. But, you know, my mother always said, give what you love. And so, you've liked it. Yeah, they've gotten really close with it. And onto Take Me Home. This is a secular, popular song. It was written by Pentatonix, two of the members of Pentatonix. That's a five-member a cappella group. I'm sure you've heard of Pentatonix. Oh, good, lots of nods. They're probably the most famous a cappella group currently in the U.S. They're from Texas, and they were on, what was it called? It wasn't called The Voice. It was something else. I don't know. The Bumblebees from U of R were, not the Bumblebees, Yellow Jackets. I don't know. I remember hearing them that first time. And so at any rate, they're very famous, and they're making a cappella music even more popular. But what they speak about in interviews, they speak about how the first verse of this song that they created when they were, you know, the five of them were coming together to put something together, and then two took the lead. That the first verse refers to the individuality of their group and of people in the world, but how it progresses to the point of the fact that we all belong together. Even as individuals, we are a together thing, and our heartbeats are what is so special. And I know that when we're singing together, we're probably all, I don't know, but medical research says, when you sing together, your beats of your hearts all go together. And it unifies us physically and emotionally. And ironically, in our discussions about this piece, Take Me Home, they talked a lot about how what did they talk about? They spoke about the same lines, about being together and supporting each other. And that's, you know, that's really important in our world, that we have individuals who understand we need to support each other. So I personally love hearing their voices come together in song, and I know that you'll like this. So take me home.
You light up in the dark. You're the glow.
Wanted to just thank David for being here tonight, David Schultz, for setting everything up for us. First of all, thanks so much for making us look so great with the lights. Truly appreciate all the support that our department, Natalie's here tonight. Thank you so much. And I think we've got video going. Tamara's here. So thank you, Tamara. Stuart, thanks for, you kind of looked at me weird when I said, I think it's all a cappella, right? But thanks for promoting all the work that these wonderful singers do. I really appreciate the opportunity to be able to work with these singers, and it's really special. You get to be involved next, though. Let me tell you a little bit about this last song, Africa, one of my favorite a cappella works to do, by Toto. You know, Toto's the band, right? And the band members, David Paish, I think is how you say his name, and Jeff Porcaro wrote this song, and Paish's lyrics were inspired, not in a personal love romantic sense at all, or a relationship sense, but it was the love for this continent of Africa. He had seen a documentary late one night about the perils and the plight and suffering that is in Africa in different societies. And so this evolved from that experience. What you're gonna hear and be a part of is the rains in Africa at the beginning. And once we start singing, you're gonna hear six different layers happening here. It's very involved, and you're gonna see these vocal instrument sounds happening, lead lines, there's duets, there's backup harmonies. Everybody gets to do a lot of different work here. They've worked very, very hard on this. And I hope that you enjoy being a part of it. So I'm gonna teach you what you gotta do.
Are you game? So they already know this game. I'm gonna be doing something like this, and when I get to you, you wanna do this. So can everybody just practice doing that? Okay, getting warmed up. And the next one is gonna be, and don't say, I can't snap, just do something. Okay. You can't snap your fingers, you can do your tongue. Okay, another one is going to be this. And if I do it faster and harder, you have to do that. Yeah, or you could do it slower, whatever you want. Okay, so there's that one, and then
clapping.
Oh, the clapping. Now, it's not like, oh, let's all clap in unison, okay? This is depicting the weather, okay? And different sounds, so it's random, okay? And then there's on the cement floor, but you have to stop at a certain time. So I know I will look ridiculous, but so will you. So hopefully you're gonna hear this rainstorm come and go, and it takes a lot of listening to imagine that, and I'm gonna give them their starting pitch. And so you'll know when to stop when they start singing. Well, plus I would have passed you and stopped, right? Okay? Okay, you get it. I think you're gonna be the first one, Stuart. So I'm starting over on cover eight. Okay, so here it is. Okay, is everybody ready? Oh, I'm not to you yet.